Hi everyone, my name is Angela, and welcome to my presentation on the impact and perceptions of continued medical education opportunities among clinicians in rural Ghana. And this is a quality improvement project on a virtual Grand Rounds program launched by the international medical charity Ghana Medical Help, for which I volunteer. So the objectives for today's presentation are first to give a brief overview on the motivation behind this project. So we'll go over the need for continued medical education in rural Ghana. I'll then give a quick description of the pilot virtual Grand Rounds program that was launched. We'll go over some preliminary results and findings, and then some future directions for the program. So continued medical education, which I'll refer to as CME moving forward, refers to a form of postgraduate training that helps those in the medical field maintain competence and learn about new and developing areas in their field, such as new diagnostic or treatment approaches. And the World Health Organization has identified CME to be one of the most important elements in improving healthcare workers' skills, knowledge, and morale. But continued medical education opportunities are quite scarce for clinicians in rural Ghana, which then hinders their ability to remain up to date on recent evidence-based practices. So all of this contributes to low morale, low clinical competence, and challenges in recruiting and retaining healthcare workers, which then further reinforces health disparities in already underserved and low-resource communities. So the pilot virtual Grand Rounds program was launched in July of 2021 by Ghana Medical Help, with the goal of improving access to CME opportunities for rural Ghanaian healthcare workers, particularly in the north. The virtual Grand Rounds program are essentially almost weekly lectures where a Ghanaian physician will present on a topic that they have expertise in. So here are these little posters that are shown above are examples of previous seminars that we've hosted. So as an example, we had one on rheumatic heart disease, snake bites, pneumonia, and sickle cell disease. So the data that I'll be sharing with you today come from 9 virtual Grand Round seminars, which were conducted between January and April of 2022. So what we did was we sent out an online semi-quantitative Qualtrics survey after each presentation, and the survey included 5 demographic questions, which included things like gender, age, and occupation. There were also 5 5-point Likert scale questions where participants were asked to evaluate the presentation they just watched, and I'll go over what those questions were when we take a look at the results section. There were also 3 open-ended feedback questions where we asked participants to freely share how they had benefited from the program and what sorts of future topics they'd like to see as part of the virtual Grand Round seminars. So here are some of the results from the demographic data that we collected. So in the top left-hand corner, you could see the respondents' field of work. So about 46% of our respondents were physicians, 11% were students, 16% were nurses, 12% were physician assistants, and 15% fell into this other category that largely included public health officers, pharmacists, and midwives. In the top right-hand corner, we have the age distribution of participants. So the vast majority of people fell into the 25 to 45 age range. In the bottom left-hand corner, we have the gender distribution of the participants. So about 78% of our respondents were male and 22% identified as female. And then in the bottom right-hand corner, we asked participants how many seminars they had attended up to that point, and about 28 had attended 1, 78 had attended 2 to 5, 37 had attended 5 to 10, and then the remainder had been to more than 10. So here are the results from the presentation-specific evaluation questions, which were based off the 5-point Likert scale. So participants were asked how strongly they agree or disagree with the statements shown here. And the 5 statements were, I have applied what I learned from past presentations in my clinical practice. I will use what I learned from today's presentation in my clinical practice. I would attend future Grand Rounds presentations. Today's presentation was interactive, and today's presentation was helpful and relevant for my clinical practice. So as you can see from this graphic, the vast majority of participants strongly agreed with all the statements, which gave us an early indication that the program was benefiting a lot of participants. I'll also mention here that the sample for each of these questions varies a little bit. So the bottom two questions were included in all 242 surveys that we collected, but in certain iterations of the survey, we scrapped the top three questions while we were experimenting with our survey design. So the top three questions only have 173 responses. We have since finalized the survey, so hopefully we'll have some more stable and consistent data in future presentations. So this is one of the tables from our manuscript, which outlines some of the qualitative data we collected from one of our open-ended feedback questions, which essentially asked participants how they had benefited from the program. And I'll clarify here that the Virtual Grand Rounds program is locally known as the Community Service Agenda, which is why the question was phrased in this manner. But two major themes came from our analysis of this question and the responses we got. So about 67% or 37 individuals gave feedback on just generalized increased or updates in their knowledge base. So example quotes can be found on the right-hand column. So for this theme, an example quote was, "It has been very helpful in improvement of my knowledge base, keeping me up to date with current trends in common case management." Another theme that came about from our analysis of this question was the application of knowledge and improved clinical performance. So about 15% of respondents gave a response along the lines of improved clinical performance. So an example quote was, "It has improved my clinical assessment and management of patients." Some other quotes are also listed on the right-hand column. So one participant wrote, "Detailed topics with current management updates on all the topics discussed. This is the best thing to happen to us doctors in rural Ghana." So now for a brief discussion on some of the early data that we collected from our assessment of the Virtual Grand Rounds program. So overall, the program is very feasible, it's quite cost-effective, and has been well received by participants. Some of the benefits of the virtual format is that it has enabled attendance from healthcare workers who would have otherwise been limited by poor road infrastructure and rainy season weather. We've also recently started recording the presentations and posting them on our YouTube channel. So if participants can't attend the presentations live, they can go back and watch the recordings later or use it as a reference study guide. Some of the early benefits we've been seeing from the program include improved clinical competency and morale, and improved recruitment and retention of physicians in northern Ghana. So when the program was first launched in July of 2021, there were only 5 physicians at the Upper West Regional Hospital where this program is based out of. And this hospital supports a population of 868,000 people. As of July of 2022, that number of physicians has over quadrupled. So now there are 22 physicians and nearly all attend the weekly Grand Rounds presentations. These new physicians reported that they would have previously rejected Northern job postings, but accepted it solely due to the ongoing learning opportunities that are now being offered to them. The program has also provided mentorship opportunities for young physicians and medical students to connect with other like-minded individuals. So to wrap things up, I'll just go over some recent accomplishments and future directions for this program. So the Ministry of Health in Ghana recently approved the Virtual Grand Rounds program for certified CME accreditation. We've also expanded the medical education program to include annual BLS and CPR training workshops. We've also been continuing with data collection, and recent iterations of the surveys includes other variables, so we can add some depth and breadth to a future analysis of this program.